There's some really unfortunate news that's going around regarding the chip shortage. Google Stadia has decided that they want to let YouTubers in on a feature that they said would be out during launch, and we now have the price of the RX 6600 series. Let's get into the hot news, my friends. I am your host, Brett. We're going to be going over the hottest tech news that I can find on the internet for you to enjoy with your morning breakfast, and you can move on with your day. So we're going to start off talking about the chip shortage and more details that are coming out from Intel. This is actually a report that happened over on WCCF Tech a few months ago, where they reported that the world is running out of substrates for people to put their chips on. You can't make a CPU or a GPU or anything in between if you don't have something to actually put that tech, like to lay the traces and do the whole thing. That is typically called a substrate, to just grossly oversimplify everything. And WCCF Tech's report said that the world's running out of substrate. Intel confirmed that in their Q2 earnings report call that they had on Friday, essentially indicating that they don't expect this to let up anytime soon, and thus they are going to be prioritizing their highest margin stuff, such as their Ice Lake server processors. And they do expect that things could potentially get back on track in 2022, late that year, or 2023. So in case you think the chip shortage is over with prices going back down, it still could be really bad for a while, or we might be through the worst of it. We might have hit the choke point that caused the prices to spike as they did back in May, but we could be at the end of it, and this is just going to be roughly higher prices for the next year or so, and not 3 to 4 times the price of what things should cost. Intel saying that they are working on finding some other substrate manufacturers, changing how they make stuff, just trying to figure out a way to get through this. But the clear and concise message that's coming out, not just from Intel, but also from AMD, NVIDIA, and other chip manufacturers, is that this is actually bad. It's not just one thing that's causing these prices to go up. It's not simply a supply and demand issue of the net product. It's a supply and demand issue of everything on the back end, from memory chips to substrates to shipping, even getting a shipping container to bring the cards over to different regions, costing way more than it ever did before. So we're gonna have to wait and see, but it could potentially get worse before it gets better. Let me know what you think of the Intel substrate shortage down below in the comments. Well, I tell you about today's episode sponsor, my friends, ButcherBox. This is a service that me and my family have been using for a while before they ever even came on as a sponsor of Hot News. And it's just so remarkably simple. It makes our life so much easier. We don't have to remember to pick up certain things at the grocery store because ButcherBox delivers all of the meat straight to our door. You get grass-fed beef, free-range organic chicken, pork-raised crate-free, and wild-caught seafood with premium meat, and it's costing less than $6 per meal with free shipping, again, straight to your door. It makes it simple. And combine that with our move to Pennsylvania, we discovered that meat prices here are way more than they were in Florida. And so we're actually saving a lot more money here in Pennsylvania than we were in Florida just by simply moving and finding out that prices are a little bit higher here. There are several different butcher boxes that you can choose from, as well as customizing your own to meet your specific needs. But if you use our link that's in the video description, you can get 2 5-ounce lobster tails and 2 10-ounce ribeyes for free in your first box. That's free lobster and free steak in your first purchase with ButcherBox. Check it out, it can be a great service. If you don't find that it's as convenient or as nice as you want it, you just cancel after the first month. You don't have to hold on to it. All right, try it out. You're gonna get free lobster and free steak, and you support us here at Hot News. So check out ButcherBox at the link in the video description. And I desperately want to check out Valve's Steam Deck. I can't wait until I get my hands on mine. It took me 93 minutes to pre-order my 512 gigabyte version. I don't know where that puts me in the queue. I don't know if I'm getting it Q2 of 2022 or if I'm in the Q4 2021 region, but regardless, there's new reports coming out. The Valve is saying that the Steam Deck can run every single game that's in the Steam library at the target frame rate and resolution that they have. They haven't found a game yet that the Steam Deck can't actually do, which I actually absolutely believe considering the specs that it has, with Valve also continuing to specify that the 30 FPS frame rate target that they have for 720p is not the average, that's actually the low. That's as low as they want you to go with the floor of the performance, and there's gonna be an optional built-in FPS limiter to make sure that you can get as much battery life as you want out of it so that you can actually have control over your device, which just mind-blowing for a console. I mean, this is why people love PC gaming, because it gives you a lot of customizations, and it seems like the Steam Deck gives you the benefits of console gaming in a portable form factor, but then also giving you all the customizations customizations that you would want from a normal gaming PC. Valve seems to be doing it right. Hopefully they do get it right. I'm very excited for the Steam Deck. I want to hear what you think of it down below. But now, my friends, it's time to find out what the world thinks of cryptocurrencies and meme stonks. But talking about the crypto stonks update, Bitcoin absolutely surging since I sat down to record. Holy crap, 13.5% increase in 24 hours. That's not the crazy thing. I sat down to record and you can see this chart only goes up to $35,800. It is currently sitting at $3,000 more than that. I'm gonna have to refresh for the chart to have the proper scale. No, it's still going up too fast. It's up to $38,500, again, increasing 14.5% in the last 24 hours, coming from below $34,000 less than 24 hours ago to now above $38,500, absolutely surging. Ethereum also having roughly the same, up 7.19% to $2,300. Dogecoin also experiencing some of that benefit, 6.38% gain to 20 cents. The meme stonks had a middling day on Friday. GameStop closing up 0.84% to 180.36. AMC down 0.67% to 36.99. Where they go today, we'll have to wait and see. Cryptocurrency absolutely taking off, even since I sat down to film, up $3,000 in just a few minutes. This is absurd. What might not be so absurd is the idea that Amazon either will soon start accepting Bitcoin or might be developing their own cryptocurrency, with them having job postings that indicate that they'll have a digital currency and blockchain strategy that will allow them to have a product roadmap and just kind of get into the world of blockchain, whatever that might mean. On the retail side, they've already had some sort of blockchain service on the AWS side. This would be them rolling it out to a different sphere, but this is not some new news, even though this is coming up right now. I reported on this back in April 10th of 2018, when I was on my American road trip, where I was staying at hotels every single night, and we talked about how Amazon was looking to potentially invest in the future of blockchain and cryptocurrency. It's been over 3 years. It hasn't super developed. It's not quickly moving, but they're getting to it, and they might have some sort of Bitcoin payment or blockchain payment sometime soon. Speaking of future technology, GM's updating their Super Cruise technology, which is their semi-autonomous driving features that they have in certain vehicles. They're going to be updating it so it can do fully automatic lane changing, have support for towing, and to show you what roads you could actually enable Super Cruise on instead of just having to guess. GM's mapped out certain roads, most of the US highways. I think it's something like 200,000 miles, but they don't exactly tell you, so new updates coming soon. But they want to get into an updated legal beef with Ford, because Ford wants to name their hands-free driving technology Blue Cruise, which GM has decided it's too close to Super Cruise. All right, we both can't cruise, all right? We're cars, not ships. So you gotta change. And GM sitting down with Ford to have a good faith arrangement, trying to figure out, can more than one cruise ever exist? Who knows? And can you get a regular steering wheel in the updated Tesla Model S and X? The answer is no, according to Elon Musk over on Twitter. With MKBHD dropping his review over the weekend on the Plaid Model S, Elon Musk saying that it was a good review and fair critique, and somebody asked, any chance of a normal steering wheel option? To which we got the dreaded, just very succinct answer of, no, you want a normal steering wheel, go buy some other car. And you want to play cloud gaming that's actually worth anything? Well, then play anything besides Stadia. But now they're rolling out the feature that they promised to have at launch, which is their Cloud Play beta. They are now inviting YouTubers to apply to test so that you can stream out to your stream people who watch you, and then they can join in on the game that you're playing. And so it could be a fun little thing. I thought about applying for it, but you have to own one of these games on Stadia, and I am not buying a game on Stadia just to make a meme video about how much I hate Stadia. And they also asked, like, what are your thoughts on Stadia? Do you like it? Do you dislike it? I wasn't about to lie. I was gonna just put, like,
as we finally get to share Google's vision for the future of games.
I was gonna put that I passionately despise that they've ever existed, but that wasn't an option on the form. I could just put that I dislike it. And I don't think they're gonna let me into that program if I say that I dislike Stadia. And a lot of people aren't disliking EVGA right now, with the reports that we talked about last week in Hot News that New World seemed to be killing off some RTX 3090 GPUs. I think EVGA confirmed that it was roughly 20 to 30 reports that they've received of cards dying, and new reports coming in that it's not just 3090s that are having issues. Well, EVGA saying that they're gonna going to be immediately replacing them and shipping out new 3090s to people's doorsteps if they had an EVGA card that died. And if in case they don't have enough replacement EVGA cards, they'll just buy one from another company and cross-shopping cards just in case to get you one because your card died and they want to take care of you. Which isn't surprising because EVGA does have some experience in replacing customer cards that, you know, died because of the 1070s and 1080s that were literally catching on fire back in 2016, but we don't know much about that. That was 5 years ago. Let's totally forget that EVGA cards caught on fire. But they fixed it. They replaced it. And here's another card that can catch on fire. We now have some new reports coming out about the 6600 and 6600 XT cards coming out from AMD. The MSRP of the 6600 XT is expected to be $349, and the non-XT version is expected to be $299. That would make them seriously price competitive with NVIDIA's lineup. Obviously, the 3060 Ti going for $399 and the 3060 going for $329. That would slot them right in between them. The 6600 XT is supposed to compete with the 3060 Ti, if not the 3070. So that $350 price point, if that's actually where they're going to exist at retail, would make it highly appealing. We're still waiting to see if these are going to launch in August or if they might get delayed, especially with all the stock issues that we're seeing. I know, you don't want to hear about new cards until you get your hands on current ones, but I can't do anything about AMD and NVIDIA releasing new cards. I can just tell you about it. I told you on Friday about AMD's next generation of GPUs and how they're going to be super, super good. So why don't you go check out that episode? Thank you so much for watching. Glad you could catch up with the tech news over your breakfast. Let's see you tomorrow in the next episode of Hot News, my friends. Cheers.